Go for 4 hours, and then we have to stop the live stream and start it again. Welcome back to Akros TV at the 2018 Nationals. We had to shut the live stream off, so hopefully you can join back in and share it again with all your friends and family so they can share it and everybody can see what's going on. All right, getting ready for the next event, which is the girls A and B divisions. We've got about five of them, and then we're going to go into the Open and Open Pro Women's International. And that'll be some amazing tricking coming up from them. And then followed by that, we'll go to the Open and Open Pro and International Men's Slalom. And that will wrap up the Open and Open Pro divisions, and then we'll be going into some jumping after that. So if you're just joining us again, sorry about that. Facebook only allows you to do a four-hour live stream. Then you must stop and basically start it over. So hopefully you guys refreshed your screens. You're back on. You're back watching again. Please give us a share and let as many people watch this as you possibly can. It only helps the sport and helps everybody progress. Hopefully we get some more sponsors, and it's a good thing. So how do I turn this music down? Is that going into the live stream? Can you guys hear that up there? All right, well, we got 6 viewers, so let's see if we can get all the way back up to 100 plus. So again, share it, guys. Let people know that they can watch it again and go from there. Pretty exciting trick finals for the Open Men's, Open Pro, and International. Some pretty amazing tricking by Jackson Girard. He followed it up yesterday. We weren't sure if he was going to be able to do it again, but he did. Up over 14,000 points. First time 14,000 has ever been broken. Pretty impressive. So first on the water, let's see, Sammy Eaton. Sammy Eaton will be the first female on the water, followed by, it's like, Ellis Osborne. Oh, we got a couple of boys A division skiers here and a boys B division as well. Then Riley Stenson, Michael Sousa, and Brett Swanbaum. I'd like to say thanks again to our sponsors. This is the footin.com U.S. Barefoot Waterski Nationals presented by visitcentralflorida.org. If you're coming to Central Florida, definitely go to visitcentralflorida.org and find out all the things to do in the area. Here we come, Sammy Eaton on the water. As she's coming down, she's settling in that curl, and then she will continue. There we go, 1 foot weight cross. Ooh, got a little low there. She thinks she might get it. Another 1 foot weight cross, looking good. Number 3, 1 foot weight cross. You got to get that foot up a little higher. Make sure you don't want those judges guessing. I put that as an early down. And number 5 right there. Pretty good, pretty good. She's come a long way. Her 1 foot's look a lot stronger than they were a couple years ago. And just I don't know how clean those were right there. They were just, that foot was really low to the water. Heel kind of looked like it was kind of bouncing and skipping. You know, you've got to make sure the judges can see everything clean and clear. Otherwise, if they do have any doubt in their mind, they may catch you. Here's a replay right here. going to cut out a little bit, pick up the foot, and there she goes. One foot. Ooh, see that? It's a little low. Another one. That was okay, it looked like. Watch this. Just watch that foot in the air. The foot in the air is just a little sketchy. Again, right here. See that? It looks like she touched down. So barefoot water skiing is so hard to judge compared to so many other sports because we have this spray. You know, since you're on such a small surface area on your feet and you get all this white water coming out around you, it's coming out left, right, behind you, and in front. You know, if you plow too much, that spray pops up. It's really tough on the judges to see what's going on. So you just try to make it as clean, as clear as you can to get the best score you can. We got the General Jackson, Gerard's father, on the jet ski down there helping out. Yeah, Ryan Boyd showed up today. Ryan, glad you came to say hi, buddy. He's got his new little kitty over there, little kiddo. How old's this dog? Four months? 4 month little black lab? Alrighty, Simeon getting ready for her second pass down there. She's probably gonna do a back deep and do some back 2 foot weight crosses. If she's not comfortable with the back deep, she'll come back forward. Yep, they're setting up right there. A little bit of fumbling around back here. Looks like she's getting ready for a back deep. Here she goes, she rolled over. Boat's taking off. Nice plant, just gonna be patient for speed now. And there she is, up backwards. Cutting out into the curl. All right, here she comes, Sammy Eaton from Wisconsin. All right, 2 foot weight cross. One, two, got a little wide there. Three, four. Oh, feet got a little wide and she just dropped that outside shoulder and fell right over. So her first score, let's see, 6.6 is what she came into this event with. And have we heard anything yet? Any provisional scores? We're waiting right now. I didn't hear anything on the front pass. We'll get you scores when we can. Once they get three or four scores from the skiers, they'll put the scoreboard up so you kind of see where they land. Here's the replay. So a really wide. Let's see. She got them together. If she could hold them right there, she'd be good. But as she pushes, she's really wide right there. Ooh, just barely over the crest. Really wide. Ooh, she almost fell right there. That's why on this next one, you'll see her fall. So she got really wide. Get onto that left foot and boom. So she pretty much just splits out there.
Just oh, and then the big old log roll. Okay, so.
All right, just to remind everybody, we are 6.4, total of 6.4 weight crosses for Sammy. And so just 0.2 less than what she came into this round with. So not horribly bad. I'm sure she, you know, we always want more. But just a reminder for everybody watching, we're going to be doing a live stream of the World Barefoot Championships east of Toronto, Canada, in a week and a half. It starts on the August 13th and goes for that whole week. So stay tuned. Watch it for that. Following that will be Footstock. The weekend after the World Championships will be August 25th and 26th. This will all be live streaming. So just mark it in your calendar. Make sure you can get on here and check it out and watch some awesome, strong competitors.
Yeah, it's going to be a fun event to watch. You've got guys from all over Europe, Australia, New Zealand, the States, Canada. People, you know, we got China, Korea, South Korea, obviously, not the North.
Yeah.
But, I mean, you have got people literally from all over the globe coming out to that event. It's a ton of good skiing, especially in the jump event, really heavily contested.
Yeah, that jump event, you just never know, you know. I mean, we got David Small flying 29 meters, but there's a couple of young kids that are throwing it out there now, too.
Oh, there's some big names out there in jump right now in the junior division. You got TJ Russell. I don't know if he's jumping in open or not. He might be saving it just for the juniors.
Oh, maybe.
But he's looking like the contender. He can jump 25-plus meters.
Wow. And you got Keenan Day. That can get out 25, 26 pretty easily. It seems like he's been posting
Franks
a lot of big jumps.
Ben Franks has got a good history
recently.
Ben Franks,
that's right, yeah.
Now that he's finally filled into that big head of his, body's really nice and thick and get some good push off the ramp.
All right, here we go. Ellis Osborne, Boys A, coming to this round with a 6.6. Let's see if he can improve. Strong little guy right here. Man, is he strong. Tough kid, smart kid, great kid to have at the ski school. Nice, clean, 1 foot weight cross. Come on, buddy. Just keep it the same all the way down. Number two. No. Oh, a little early there. We got to make sure we ski all the way through. Ooh, another little bobble. Number five. Six. You know, it's pretty tough out there sometimes. You get the nerves. You're trying to ski your best, and you kind of feel a couple little rollers here and there, what have you, and you get a little nervous, and you get kind of lay back a little bit on the heel. So it all depends. I was working some back 1 foot weights with him the other day at the school, and he was looking really good. He was coming along really well, so hopefully he's able to actually pick one side up. So basically we started at the ski school just doing 2 foot back weight crosses, and then, of course, you know, 80-20, 90-10, get all the way over there. And then he looked so good on 90-10, it's like, okay, just start picking one up. And he started picking 1 foot up backwards. So we'll see if he throws it. I don't know if he's going to take a chance of doing it here or not, but we'll find out. Any no provisional scores yet?
Yeah, nothing there yet on Alice's first pass there. Keith is probably still telling it up in the boat. But he is one of two in the Girls A event. Oh, sorry, Girls A. Boys A event here. So he's got some tough competition there with Mike Sousa. So Alice definitely wants to give it everything he can. Try and take that gold medal from Mike.
Yeah, Mike Sousa, he has a score of 8.5 and Ellis is 6.6. So I know Mike has been just learning his back 1 foot weight slalom too. I'm like, he can do it. He's just not overly consistent. So it's kind of what we look for here. If you can be consistent in a tournament like this, you're going to end up right where you need to. After this division, we will go into the Open Women's and International. And we will have the Tricks event. Carol Jackson, Riley Stenson, Lauren Ehlers, Rachel Norman, Terry Jones, Alex Youngblood, Ashley Stebbings, and Lexi McCulley.
Dave Miller, yes, you did miss the jumping today. It was first thing this morning, 7 o'clock Eastern time. That's 6 o'clock Wisconsin time. You probably still would have been awake from the night before, maybe.
Yeah, maybe. But, yeah, they did it early because we've been having a lot of storms come in through the afternoon, so jumping is that sketchy thing that we always need good water for, so they don't feel like challenging and trying to beat the weather. Here we go. We got Ellis Osborne coming backwards. Let's see what he does here. Is he going for the back 1 foot? Not yet. He's a start on two. Get that all that weight on that 1 foot as he's driving. And looks like he's sticking with the two. Might not pick up here. Oh, there it was. Oh. Yeah, I think he nearly had that all the way across. Let's watch right here. One more. Pick it up. Oh, those are his first couple back 1 foots in a tournament. That's pretty cool. He went for it. Good job, buddy. Well done. Okay. There's his replay. Nope, leaned into it a little bit on that one. Ooh, look at that. Look at that. He's going for it, man. He just learned these the other day. No joke. Just started picking that sucker up. Going for it again. Ooh, not bad at all, buddy. Well done. Well done. And one more. That's good. That is really good. Good job. Good job, Ellis. Look at that. All the kids down there swimming. Having a good old time. Dogs are playing, barking up a storm over here. Hey, Boyd. All that barking, you know.
Petter Knowledge Construction is a proud sponsor of the 2018 U.S. Barefoot Nationals and Team Ehlers.
Seen you in a while. How's things going? Want to come and talk a little bit? Say hi to everybody online here. Come on in, man. Brian Hetherington here. Been on the senior world team. Yeah, you're on the live stream, buddy. Been on the senior world team a few times. Your mic is on. You want to talk a little bit? What do you think, man? Well, hold on. We got a skier coming up here. This is Riley Stenson coming up for her first pass. And we're going to ask Brian some questions after. Here we go. Nice, clean, 1 foot weight. Number two, get some nice drone footage right from over top. Look how cool that is. Number three. Number four. Oh, solid as a... Oh, shoot, right when I mentioned it, too. She had that little misstep there, but everyone else looked good. So, Brian, man. So, I get some good questions for you. Yeah. What do you most miss about barefoot water skiing? Hold it nice and close to your mouth.
I don't know. It was a good time competing with everybody. Training, it was always fun.
Do you like training? You like competing with everyone?
Yeah.
What are the things you don't miss about it? Your time in rough water. What about the falls? You don't miss those?
Yeah,
those are fun. Yeah, exactly. Makes it good for the people in the boat, too. Give them a little entertainment on falling.
Is it? How's that? Can you hear me?
There we go. Now we can hear you.
No, back in March, I got in a motorcycle wreck. Oh. Collarbone and all the upper ribs in my back and my left shoulder. So
really?
So I'm kind of out of commission for... all year, so.
Wow, so you got a...
Recovering from that pretty good. Might be able to ski in about another month or so.
Have you been skiing at all? You been on the water a little bit or not?
No.
No.
No, there's no way. Not yet. Maybe in about a month I might be able to...
ski again? Okay,
we'll
cool.
See.
So you said you got in a motorcycle wreck, broke his collarbone and a few things. So the big question is, when you got in the wreck, did you tuck and roll like a barefoot fall? Like, were you, like, instincts kick in or what?
No, I was wanting to a corner too fast, and it... kind of slid down and slammed me on my left shoulder, and I was pretty much pinned under the bike until
really?
Someone helped get it off.
Oh, my goodness, dude. That's scary. Wow, so you can't blame it on someone else.
Nope, it was all me.
Oh, man. But you're okay. The bike can always be fixed, and you're riding again. Good?
Yes, sir.
Cool, man. Awesome. Glad to have you here. All right, so we have Riley Stenson down there. I did not get her that provisional score. I missed it. I was talking to Bri. But we'll get a scoreboard up here in a little bit. They'll put it on upstairs in the booth. AJ's working hard, and they'll get a scoreboard on there for us eventually. All right, here she comes, back pass. She's been getting their back slalom. One foot's kind of getting, they're getting pretty good too. She literally just started doing these about a week ago. Like, she can do them. They're just a little inconsistent, so I think she's going to start on two. And then pick up one. Looks like she tried to pick up one there. There we go. There's a back 1 foot. Nice. And there's another back 1 foot. Holy cow. Look at this girl go. Yeah. That a girl. No joke. I mean, she was doing them like 2 weeks ago, but just like crazy scary. She took up hard falls, and she kind of got pulled back a little bit and then got a little defensive. And now we kind of worked on it again last week. And there you go. She's got a couple back 1 foot weight crosses there. All right, people. We only got 20 people watching. Come on, share it on Facebook so the other people can see. Get it out there. Too bad we have to refresh after 4 hours on Facebook. You have to cut your live stream and then start it all over again. So we had like 100 people following, and then they all dropped off. They got to come back on again. Yeah. What are the thoughts you have, Bri?
Well, not too much. Looks like a lot of new faces around here. Still some of the old ones.
6.6 total for Riley on both those passes. Yep, 6.6. So she touched down on a few forward. She tried the back 1 foot. Looks like she got cut on a few, so ended up with 6.6. Previous score coming in here was 7.5. So she won't be overly happy with that, but still, it's just kind of a warm-up for Worlds. We'll look back at this tournament and say, okay, what do we need to fix? What do we need to work on? And from that point on, we will work on what we have to prepare for the World Championship. She is on the Junior World Team. So that is a pretty cool thing. It's something she's always wanted to do and achieve. So it's awesome.
All right, Keith, I'm going to go say hi to some people, and I'll talk to you later.
Yeah, go catch up. Go catch up with some people, Brian. Nice seeing you, man. You and I skied a lot together in the past when I first moved to Winter Haven.
Oh, yeah.
Good friend and one of my best buddies right here. We had a lot of good times on the water, off the water, and did a lot of training together, so it was fun. Glad to see you, man. Next skier. I hold him dear to my heart. He's from New Hampshire, where I'm from. Uh-oh. What happened there? Did he miss a start? Swimming back. I guess he's got to get a re-ride. What happened? Weeds on the prop. The boat had to stop, had some weeds on the prop. Couldn't really take off. It was probably just cavitating a little bit, so they stopped the boat. So he let go. So that's what's happening there. So we're going to we got a little commercial. This might take a little bit. You guys should put a little commercial in there and get some of that cool video out there. We're going to have to wait a little bit. Boats have to circle around, get that rope tight again, and then go from there. All right, questions. Who do we have? Brett Sands is back on. Hey, Keith. I hope you're well. I am well. I'm doing great, Sandy. Looking forward to seeing you. I'm looking forward to seeing you too, my friend. It's going to be fun. Glad you are, I can't say out of retirement because you never went into retirement. I've been told that. And when they said that you were retired, they said, no, no. You said, I'm coming back and I'm going to ski again, so they can't say I'm in retirement. So, man, it's great to have you back out. It's going to be cool to see you at Worlds. You're skiing good. I've been watching you. It's good stuff, man. Dave Miller. Oh, you're at a casino, huh, Dave? Yes, you can watch this morning's jumping on footin.com or acros.tv on the Facebook and go back down, scroll through the that front page, and you can find the live stream. Everything that live streams, once we cut it off, it's saved, and you can go back and watch it again. So, yeah, definitely go back and check it out for sure. You want to come up here? Come on up, man. What's up, buddy? Tell everybody who you are.
Bryson.
Bryson. What's your last name?
Mace.
This is Bryson Mace, and he skis on the Cypress Garden Show Ski Team. And you came out to ski with us not too long ago at the ski school. We did a free day for all the Cypress Garden skiers out there. And so what do you think? You're out here. You're checking it out. What do you think about all this?
It's pretty cool.
You ever want to try it? Oh, hold on 1 second. We got Mike Sousa on the water, cranking out those front 1 foot wake slalom passes here. What's that, number 4 or 5? 6. Oh, he's looking good. 7, nice and clean. Looking solid. Mike Sousa down from New Hampshire. Oh, there we go. Bo must have been slowing down. He took a little tumble. But he'll come on his backwards, and hopefully we see some back 1 foot wake slalom. So what is the one thing you love about barefooting more than anything? All right, think about it for a second. Maybe I'll help you out. Maybe it's cool because you don't have any skis on your feet. Pretty cool, isn't it? Just standing on the water all by yourself. No wakeboard, no skis, no nothing. What's your favorite trick?
Probably front to back.
Front to back. Everybody loves the front to back. 5.7 for Mike Sousa's first pass. Front to back, he says, because front to back's cool. I agree, because not a lot of people do it. Right? It's like really challenging to learn a front to back. It's going to take some falls, and not a lot of people do it. So front to back, I'd agree with you. I think that's one of the coolest tricks out there. What's one of your favorite barefoot videos out there?
I don't know.
You don't know. You watch them all, I bet, don't you? You watch every single one? All the ones that come out at WBC, you go on the YouTube channel and check them all out?
Yeah.
Good, good. What did you learn when you came to the ski school about, what was it, two, three months ago? What did you learn out there?
A toe hold.
Toe hold?
Yeah.
And was it hard?
Kinda.
This kid learns everything fast. He's a little tough dude right here. Good, man, good. So tell us what all the acts you do on the show ski team with Cypress Gardens.
I barefoot, wakeboard, jump, and that's pretty much it.
All right, what do you do off the jump? Anything? You throwing any tricks?
I'm throwing helis.
Did you hit any yet?
No.
Oh, close?
Once.
Once? So you landed a heli?
No.
Close, though.
Yeah.
That's good, man. That's good. See, barefoots, he wakeboards, he jumps, he does it all. He's a show skier, man. That's good. So tell us, what's the story with the hair?
I dyed it.
Why?
Because me and my friends... Every summer we'll dye our hair different color. So
just for fun, having a good time. Cool. So who else dyed their hair?
My neighbors.
Your neighbors. Oh, here we go. Mike Sousa on his back pass. Here we go. There's a back one. He's nailing these things. He's going for it. Come on, buddy. Get him up there. There's a clean one. Nice back one. Get it up there. All right. Let's see if we can get one more in here. Here we go. Oh. There's another one. Woo, those are some of the first back 1 foot weight crosses he's done. That is awesome. Wow, good job, Mike Sousa. Let's check out. Let's see what this total score is going to be. That's probably going to put him in first place, I'm guessing. I didn't get Ellis's score earlier, but I think that's just going to edge him out. Nice game by Mike Sousa. Okay, next up on the water is going to be Brett Swambaum. This kid, wow, man. Like most kids that come to ski school, they're like anybody else. You know, they learn just as fast or slow as anybody else. It's just kind of just plugging away. And oh, here, let's look at this replay from Mike Sousa. Went for the back first back cross, 1 foot, didn't get it. Went for the reverse, probably said forget it. But look at this. Closer. And goes for one more on the reverse. And watch this one. 1 foot weight cross. Clean and smooth and all the way across. That is so, so cool. So little Brett Swambaum coming up, 14 years old. Just a little squirt. No, he's younger than that. How old is Brett Swambaum? 13, isn't he? 13 years old. And this kid, man, he's been putting some time into it. He's got a passion for the sport. Watch him slalom. He just jams out there for a little guy. Oh, is it the Brett Slalom Swambaum? All right.
How old is he again?
12. He's 12, see? These kids ski so good, you think they're just older, but he's 12 years old. I don't know if I heard that right. 6.3 total. Not sure if that's accurate or not, but we'll find out. We'll have the scoreboard coming up later. AJ, we're gonna. It's so loud. Let's see here. Let's turn this down a little bit. We'll get a scoreboard up here. AJ's working on it. I know he is up in the booth. 12 years old, this little guy. Watch this little guy, man. He's top seed at 10.5 crosses. He just wait. You got to just watch this kid. This kid is awesome. All right, I want to give a thanks to our sponsors. We have WordPress Offline Marketing Solutions. They do all kinds of different prints, printing of anything. You can contact Patrick Falgner at, I'll give a phone number out here if you need anything printed. He can do anything and everything. That's where we get all our posters made for the WBC. His number is 419-450-0796, Homewood Press. He is the guy to go to. Fellow barefoot water skier, so we try to give our barefoot water skier fellow guys our business. Here he comes, Brett Swambaum. Coming on his first pass. All right, just getting outside of the wake. Watch this guy, man. He just jams out there, testing out the water. Yep, it's fast enough. Here we go. Boom, you see him crank into that thing? Wow, is that fast. Number three. Number four. Oh, it's looking good. Five. Six. Look how strong this dude is. Seven. Eight. Oh, man, dude. What do you think of that skiing?
It's pretty cool.
Pretty cool, huh? 12 years old. How old are you?
10.
10 years old? Whew, you can be doing that. What's up, Miss Betsy? ABCA president. The Water Warriors event, I don't think so. Yeah, I haven't talked to Robbie yet. I missed it. Missed it again. 7.0. Wow, 7 in 15 seconds. I got Dylan over here just going, oh, my goodness, because Dylan can't even quite do that. So he's like 12 years old. How's this kid get so many intel? Look at this. Look at him. Look at this replay. Solid, smooth, driving, clean, awesome. I mean, this kid just gets after it. They live in North Tampa, Land O'Lakes. Dad's building a house on a beautiful lake up there, and they ski as often as they possibly can. So we're going to see him come back backwards and do some back 1 foot weight crosses. 7 points right there. Wow. Seven. Yep. That's pretty awesome.
Yeah, so how you doing, buddy?
Doing pretty good, Swamp Man. It's hot out here, but you know what? It's glassy.
I don't
mind sweating if we got nice flat water. No problem at all.
Where are we at here? What's going on? Do we have some hot competition going?
Yeah, so. I haven't been hearing all the different scores coming in from talking with people.
We don't have a walkie-talkie? Yeah,
I do. I've just been talking with people, interviewing people. You get that. I'm putting you in charge of that.
Get somebody here to be in charge of this.
But a scoreboard. I keep on telling AJ up there in the booth to put the scoreboard up so we can see all the scores. I think he's paying attention a little more than I am.
Where are we at now?
Brett Swanbaum's going to be on his second pass here, and then we're going into the...
Which is coming in now. Here he comes.
Yep, there he is. You see his front run? Oh, look at that. Nice. Nice and clean. All the way through.
That's
beautiful. Oh, he touched on, but he picked it up before he went.
Three.
Man. Look at this guy, 12 years old.
Four.
He's solid. Look at him.
Five.
He's strong.
So we'll see what he gets for, you know, on time here.
Is this going to be a PB for him?
Jesus, look at the old man run. Don't fall.
The old man is running. He's checking it out. He's all excited.
Yeah.
This isn't his personal best. Is it 10.5?
Yeah. Yeah, that's his beat.
Oh, so he just slammed through that then.
Well, no, we don't know. He gets cut. He gets 7 forward.
Those are all clean. He probably got, what, 5 in time?
I don't know. We'll find out.
Yeah. I'm confident. Those are beautiful. I was looking from the drone. Did you see that drone footage? Awesome.
Yeah. And he's by himself in that division. Who won the...
B? Yeah, you're right. He's by himself.
Michael Suso got what, 6.3?
There we go. Nice. Ooh, man. Gosh, he's strong for a little 12-year-old. He's a little skinny thing, too. He's strong out there. Remember when he first came to the ski school?
Yep, trust me.
Oh, my goodness.
Trust me, I remember.
Oh, we were like, we don't know if this kid's going to make it. He's just, like, all skin and bones, and sure enough.
And you think he's you think he's tough to deal with. Boy, you ought to try dealing with his old man.
Wow.
Hey, PB for Brett Swanbaum. He got a total of 12.
I knew it, man.
His PB before that was 10.5.
Wow.
So he went from 10.5 to 12. Shatters his PB by 1.5.
Beautiful.
Congratulations
skiing.
To Mr. Swanbaum.
Beautiful skiing. That was awesome. So solid.
Oh, I don't mess with any of them. I don't mess with no grandma.
There he goes. He skied awesome. He's going to be so pumped up. He's been working hard, too, at the ski school, man, hasn't he? That kid skis his butt off.
Yeah, he does. He skis hard. He's with the other kids. They work hard, ski hard, you know. You know, it's a long, grinding summer at the ski school, so you don't know that, though, because you're not there.
I have my own long, grinding summer on the road.
But, you know, all these kids, Ashley, myself, you know, well, David's out selling real estate, and you're out there traveling the Midwest, and...
You guys are putting these kids through the ringer.
But, yeah, it's a long, grinding summer. And these kids, I'll tell you, they ski hard. They play hard. They get a lot done, I'll tell you. And they wear us out.
And that's what people need to realize. And that the kids that come down and spend weeks and months at the school, it's all about water time. And if you can get a lot of water time in with pure glass water, you're going to excel faster than most people. And that's one thing we get to provide at the ski school. Glassy water and a lot of skiing.